Hello everyone, hope you are doing good after lockdown. And today our topic is gravure printing. I'm giving you a lecture on gravure printing according to your syllabus. Please, after completing this video, you will find a feedback on description, either on description or on Google Classroom. Please fill the feedback form also, and if you find any difficulty, then you can report the difficulties on the, over there. Okay, let's move. As we know that we have four conventional method of printing process, I'm skipping the history part for a time being. Okay, as we know, we have four major conventional method of printing. Okay, all are divided according to image carrier, due to different image carrier, and there are plates, cylinder, stencil, you know everyone. Okay, all printing process have basically two separate surface, that is image area, okay, that is image area and non-image area. So basically ink is applied on image area, or we can say the image area receive a ink and transfer into the paper substrate. This is the only theory of printing. And non-image area does not accept the ink, okay, they simply oppose the ink, and the image area accept the ink, and then after that it transfer into paper or other substrate, that other substrate including poly pouch, polyfilm, and polyfilm is like PP, polyethylene, polypropylene, BOPP, bioxylic polypropylene, there are, okay, let me, so basically we have four types of image carrier or printing process. Relief printing process, in which image area are on raised side, right, this is image area. Non-image area are on the recessed side, okay, this is image area, this is on recessed side, that's all. Whereas in screen printing, silk screen printing, the ink is passes through a stencil, through a wire mesh. Next is lithography, in which image and non-image area both lies on the same plane. For example, this is image, okay, this area is non-image, and I means non-image, this area is non-image, this area is image area, both are not physically separated, they both are chemically separated. Okay, the next one is intaglio. For a timing, it is gravure printing. Okay, the next one is intaglio printing, in which the image area is in depth. This is image area, this is non-image area. Okay, this is for intaglio printing. And image ink are filled over there on the image area, and the non-image area, which is on rear upper side, that's on the surface side basically, and it's wipe, there's a device called doctor blade. Later on we will show you the image also. There's a device called doctor blade which wipe off the ink from the upper or top surface, that is called non-image area surface. It wipe from non image area surface. So for example, let's draw it again. Suppose this is image area, this is non image area. I apply ink over there, so it filled, it lies on their part also. So after that I put a doctor blade, there is a blade, doctor blade will show you the image also. At certain angle it lies on there and it wipe off all the ink from the unwanted area. Okay, let's now move on. Choice of method depending upon the nature of web, which type of web, either it's a sheet fed or web fed. Hope you know that sheet fed or web fed, there is a basically two types of feeding method. In sheet fed offset, in sheet fed the feeding system are by individual sheet. Okay, there is a sheet with a specific size, they feed with individual sheets, whereas in web a continuous sheet feed through a infeeding system. Okay, we'll show you this also. Rheology of ink, rheology basically liquidity of ink, fluidity of ink. Generally in it's common in graver ink, liquid ink is used. Solvent basically two types of solvent are used, basically two uses of solvent. One is for lamination, here we are not talking about lamination. Second is for drying. Solvent. Okay. Toluene solvent is used and it is for drying. Okay. Next is coating. Coating is for further enhancement, aqua coating or etc. Speed, width, layers of coating, applying simultaneously. Okay. Cost consideration, another important part. Environment consideration, another important part. Let's give a brief also. Cost consideration is like, we will discuss about this also, but among all the printing process, gravure is the most costliest printing process initially because of their initial cost. Okay, that cost are cylinder preparation. We will discuss about this also. I'm giving a brief. Environment consideration, that's also very important because somewhere these process leaves some kind of hazardous fumes or something which is harmful for human. Okay, now we move on to next slide. They are basically, I'm showing you a picture. This is screen printing, we all know how it works. SQC screen meshes, wire, film and then substrate. Okay, next is relay printing. We know it's like letterpress flexography. Flexography is also an example of relay printing, where image area are in ray side and non image area in recess side. Okay, that's all. Now we'll discuss about this first, about this one. Planography, where image and non image area both lies on same plane. Okay, basically what is important, basically there is two types of area: image area Let me clean it. Image and non-image area. So we have to distinguish these two. Either they are lying on the same plane or on different plane. Either they are physically separated or chemically separated. So here in offset it is chemically separated, here in both they are physically separated. Okay, so in intaglio printing, or we can say gravure printing, gravure printing, the image area is in recess. Okay, this is image area and this is non-image area. Hope you can see my cursor. This is non-image area and this is image area. You can see the ink is filled over there. Okay, and here it is non-image area and it wipe the ink from the non-image area. Let's move to next. This is the example of gravure printing process. There's a ink tank, or you can say ink pen. Most important is cell. In this area, if this is image area, this is image area, this is non-image area. Non-image. In gravure, we call it as cell. The lower part, the depth part is called as a cell. Okay. See, this is how it works. Working. Paper is feeding from this side. Let's example, there is a reel. Paper is feeding. As I already told you, the web is feed. Generally, web is fed on gravure printing. So there is a continuous sheet, or you can say web is feeding over there. Okay, there is a impression cylinder, rubber is mount over there. There is a gravure cylinder, basically it is copper made with chromium plating. We will discuss about why we do chromium plating. Okay, just to enhance the life, basically. Okay, this is ink tank, this is ink. Okay, cylinder is moving on this direction. Okay, on clockwise direction. There is a doctor blade. Generally doctor blade have a certain angle which is not exactly 90 degree. This is wrong. Basically it has some angle just like this, which is near to 45 degree. Okay, you cannot put cylinder with this angle, as whenever it rotate it can hurt the cylinder easily. Although in this angle again there is chances of wear out of cylinder, and after 1 million, even near to this, after 1 million of copies, we used to replace or sharp the cylinder. Okay, so initially, see how it's work. Initially cylinder is rotating this way. There is this area which is depth or cell is a image area, this is non-image area. Hope you can see my cursor. Let me clean this again. This is non-image area, this is image area. The cylinder is moving on this angle. Okay, so now it is completely dip. This is liquid ink. Now it completely dipped and it's moving. So after after a point. This ink is lying on image area as well as on non-image area. For this, Dr. Blade play a very vital role that wipe the ink from the image area. Okay, hope you get this, and else we will show you another image. Now move. Selection of the best printing method for a particular types works depend upon the numbers of factors. There is a types of substrate. Basically, it's saying how we select a printing process. Suppose I ask you, choose a printing process for a certain, for a particular job. Suppose I ask you to print a envelope or print a brochure or something like a Delhi University brochure. So now you have to choose which printing process you will choose. So it's all depend upon either budget and print availability. There's many factors which are involved in this. So why we choose gravure printing? Why? Because of substrate. There is a higher range of substrate we can print. We can print paper, which is common. Generally, we don't print paper. Poly pouch, polythene. Okay, there are variety of poly pouch, BOPP, bioxylic polypropylene, polyethylene, polypropylene, double LDP, low density LDPE, HDP. These are the types of polythene. Okay. Next is thickness. Okay, so in gravure printing, in offset printing, we maximum to maximum we can print up to 35 GSM paper, which is almost tough, almost very much tough, but still we can print up to 35 GSM. Newspaper GSM are 48-50 GSM. Okay, sorry. And this is Bible paper, or we use similar types of paper near to 35-40 for dictionary also. Dictionary, I'm sorry again to start it. Width of substrate, width basically cylinder is like this, it rotate in this way. So we know this is a circumference, this is a width. Okay, this is a circumference, this area is circumference, this is width. Okay, so width of substrate is also important, because by this we know that how much by the width we can print. This is infinity. Circumference is a infinity because paper is feeding, but there must be some width also, which is very important. Okay, full or partial printing. Full printing is like basically in offset printing we have clamping area. You have seen the cylinder also in offset. Let me again, in offset you have seen that there is a clamping area in a cylinder. Okay, mounting area basically. We'll show you like see, in offset printing there is a clamping area. This area is a clamping. Plate is clamped from this side and mount over there, and then again lock in this way. Okay, so basically this area is waste. This area is waste in offset printing. If you have seen the actual machine, then you must have noticed that this area is almost waste. You cannot do a continuous printing. So for this gravure, in gravure, let me clean it. I don't know why it's, sorry for that. Okay, now it's in gravure printing. We have, there is a no lock area. This is complete a printing area. Okay, this all area are completely printing area. So you can continuously print without any break. And handling after printing. Among all printing process, gravure is the most easiest. We can say easiest or the make ready process. We'll discuss about make ready and pre-make ready. Among all, gravure has the least make ready time required. Okay, we'll get back to this topic. Cleanup, again, there is a very less make ready time, and basically it's the easier to clean because of less numbers of cylinder. Why I'm saying this, I'm show you. See, this is a complete printing machine. Wait, I will show you. This is a complete printing machine. If we see, this is a complete printing machine with numbers of unit. 8 color. Okay, so you can see there is only one cylinder, that second cylinder roller, we can call it roller. This is a guiding roller, this is cylinder, printing cylinder. There must be a ink tank also. So there is very lesser numbers of cylinder. So it's, we can say, cleaning process is very much easier in gravure printing as compared to other printing process, because their numbers of roller are lesser. Okay, now what is pre-make ready and make ready? Pre-make ready is basically, make ready is basically a process which has to be done for next upcoming job up to the first okay impression. I give you again, make ready, pre-make ready. Okay, all work done till first okay print. Okay, till first okay print, all works done are called make ready. Okay, that means suppose you are cleaning the machine, suppose you are changing the cylinder, suppose you are filling up the ink, in case offset there is a dampening solution, filling up the dampening solution, and that's all, setting up the pile, delivery height, feeding height, these all are in make ready process. Up to, even after running, up to first okay print is just like up to registration setting. For example, suppose we set everything, we set cylinder also, we set like feeding also, paper feeding also, everything, but because of poor registration, we are not getting, we won't get proper registered image. For this we have to set the registration layout also, feeding system also. That's all covers in make ready process. What is pre-make ready process? it is very simple. The process which done before make ready or pre make ready. Now how it's evaluate, suppose you basically, there is another definition, all the work done on a floor, second floor shop basically printing area, all the work done on a floor are called make ready, but all the work done off the floor means away from the floor are called make ready process. For example, I am cutting a paper on a warehouse, I am making cylinder, cutting paper, okay, these are make ready process, these are the planning which done for a next job, but make ready whereas these for very much next job, okay. Now moving to, basically we have, as already discussed, we have six types of printing: roto, screen, offset, letterpress, flexo. Digital printing process, you know that door nozzle, how it works, it's the works through a nozzle, through a spray, okay. Now let's discuss rotogravure. Industrial name is intaglio printing and rotogravure printing. We will discuss. Roto means round. Basically, the gravure printing machines comes with a round cylinder. Okay. It always comes with a round cylinder. That's why it's called rotogravure. Okay. Second, industrial name of gravure is intaglio printing or intaglio. Okay, next one is a rotogravure. Theek hai, that's same web feed except small press. Yes, there is a small presses which we call proof press. For example, generally if we are using it for a production, then we use a web feeding machine. Web feeding means a reel, okay. Whereas for a proofing, suppose we have to check the cylinder, suppose for a demonstration we use small press, small machine, and for small machine we can fed by sheet, okay. Rewound means again reeling it, again wound, it's making its roll again, okay. You can either make it roll again or cut into the sheet. Basically, why it's necessary, let me give you some. Okay, why it's necessary? Basically, when initially you printed a web, just because you know why we print web. Because it gives speed. There is no individual feeding. No individual feeding. That's why we get say higher speeds. Okay, which increase the production also. And second thing, especially in packaging industry, we need sheets, we need to fill the sheet to make a pouch. How it works, again let me explain again. Initially we feed a web, then we print both side color, 4 color, 6 color or whatever in both side. After that we put the web or reel at some corner and then wait till within a month or 2 month, depend upon manufacturer. The manufacturer, for example, suppose we discuss about Ashirvad Atta. Okay, initially today I print label and पाउच फॉर आशीर्वाद. ओके, इट इज़ नॉट कंपल्सरी, इट इज़ नॉट मैंडेटरी दैट प्रिंटिंग मशीन एंड फिलिंग आटा फिलिंग मशीन इज अटैच टू ईच अदर. ओके, दैट्स जनरली हाउ इट्स वर्क. इनिशियली इन एट वन हाउस एट वन यूनिट देर इज अ प्रिंटिंग, देन द रील मूव्स टू अनदर यूनिट देर इज अ फिलिंग यूनिट. ओके, देन that web again used for filling up. For this we need web instead of sheet, so we need to rewound it. Okay, we need to rewound, or you can cut into the sheet also by a slitter. We'll discuss. Here it is. Discuss is used to device for you to slit the web into web. Example tape. Okay, just few minute or I know it is almost 30 minutes. Thanks for your patience. I know you are taking a pain, and but still you can watch it again, up to you. Okay, but in the end, this is for brief introduction, and we will discuss live on class, video class also. Just wind up. Okay, simplest of all printing machine, we know that this is very simplest, fastest printing setup. This is very easiest printing machine. It's very easy. Very little paper waste, only half of offset. Very little paper waste. What does it mean? It means that the wastages are very low. Waste, why it is? Because of there is a lesser number of roller. When there is a lesser number of roller, there is a lesser chances of defects such as scumming, which come because of dampening solution, that's eliminate. Hickeys, grinding, doubling, the ghost effects, all these effects may minimize or cut off. Speed is extremely high. This is one of the most important factors, or most important why we choose Gravure. It gives the highest speeds, one of the highest speed. 45,000 impression per hour, you can easily get the, even in offset we used to print 8,000 impression per hour. This is general, few of them seen 20,000, but for a smooth or quality works we used to print 8 to 10,000. Okay, now next is it prints some run 20 million copy without cylinder wearing out. Basically the only issue with Gravure printing is its cylinder life and blade life. So basically it gives up to 2 crore of impression. That's almost huge. Okay, let me, for example, if you talk about offset, it gives 50,000 copies for a single plate. Okay, deep edge in offset, especially wipe on. Let me clean it. Offset in wipe on near to 50,000. Okay, deep edge These are types of plates, nearly 2 lakh. Okay, PS plates also give 1 lakh. Okay, for gravier, it gives nearly 10 lakhs lakh print, which after securing the cylinder, we can get up to crore of impression, up to crores of impression. Generally we get 10 lakhs of impression. It gives highest image quality. It gives the highest image quality. If we talk about best color reproduction, then there is no near competition with gravier printing machine. Although now we are getting very much tough competition with flexography, but still gravier is far better. This is machine. You can see this is a machine cylinder, niche pen, and then cylinder, minor cylinder. Okay, this is gravier cylinder. These are used in 3 sectors. I'm just finishing. I guess 35 minutes is more than enough. Thanks for your patience, and please give a feedback also. Thank you so much. And if any doubt, any query, you can post on Classroom.